Hey, happy Wednesday. We're glad you're joining in with us today. I pray today you're having a great day. The truth of it is, I know some of you are not probably having the best day ever. If you're a believer in God and Jesus Christ, I'm going to point you to 1 Peter 1:8. Peter talks about inexpressible joy. Joy is totally different than happiness. Happiness is the external, everything going on around you, but joy is something that's inside of you. And when Peter talks about inexpressible joy, Peter was going through some of the worst things in the world, including his upcoming death. But he understood that God saw all and was involved in all. And no matter how it looked on the external, he believed, and we believe, that God knows all. And God is in the process of working everything out. And when you have that kind of faith, no matter how bad the storm is outside, when there's calmness inside, your joy will resurface. Here's a question. If you lost your joy this year, whether it's through what's going on that you see on TV or at work or at home or in personal relationships, here's what I want you to do. Relinquish trying to control and fix everything. Spend more time in prayer, but spend the majority of time in prayer thanking God. Maybe for that loved one you have. Maybe for your family. Maybe you don't feel like you have the best job, but why not spend some time thanking God that you have a job when there are millions of people here in America who don't have a job? Maybe your home is not what you wanted. Why don't you spend some time thanking God that you have a home when there's millions of people who live on the streets? Instead of worrying that you're not having filet mignon and lobster and maybe you're having a bologna sandwich, how about spending some time thanking God that you have something to eat when there's billions of people throughout the world starving? When we get our minds focused and we start having an attitude of gratitude and realizing that the God of heaven and earth is clothing you, feeding you, ensuring that you have everything, including some really great relationships, you'll start to get your joy back. But if all you do is focus on what you don't have or what you have is not what you think you should have, you'll never get your joy. Listen, I want you to have inexpressible joy in the midst of chaos and confusion. People see everything around you falling apart, but you still have a great attitude. You have inexpressible joy. Then they will see your faith in action. Amen? Hey, I pray you have a great church home, that you're plugged in, and you are diving into discovering who God is and Jesus more and more every day. And if you don't, we'd love to invite you here on our campus. We have multiple services. Join us at one of our three services or join us online. We'd love to have you. And in case someone hasn't told you lately, God loves you, and so do we. I'll see you soon.